Today, malaria claims 90% of its victims in Africa, so people tend to think of it as a tropical disease. But both the parasite that causes malaria and the mosquitoes that transmit it can survive over large swaths of the planet. And until recently, malaria regularly killed people all over the world. In fact, the disease got its name relatively far from the tropics. Italians called it malaria, or bad air, because they thought it was caused by noxious fumes emanating from swamps. But Europe no longer has malaria, nor do other temperate places, including North America, Australia, and Northern Asia. That's partly because temperate countries developed more quickly. As people drained wet areas for agriculture, mosquitoes lost their breeding grounds. And as people gained wealth, they spent more time inside, where mosquitoes couldn't reach them as easily. But climate also helped, because once the parasite spreads from a person to a mosquito, it needs time to develop into its infectious stage before getting transferred to another human. The cooler the weather, the more slowly it develops, and under about 15 degrees Celsius, it can't reach its infectious stage at all. So in temperate climates, fewer mosquitoes end up carrying the infectious form of the parasite than in the tropics. And as a result, eradicating malaria has just been easier to do in temperate places. We have managed to knock out malaria in some tropical countries, but in Africa, malaria has been especially hard to fight. And that's largely because the main mosquito that transmits malaria in Africa loves humans. It bites our species 4 times more often than it bites other animals, whereas malaria-carrying mosquitoes outside of Africa bite other animals more often than they bite us. So today, 400,000 people in Africa die from malaria every year. But thanks in part to a huge increase in the number of people using bed nets, that's just half as many people as malaria killed in Africa 15 years ago. But whether or not we'll be able to fully eliminate malaria in Africa, well, that is still up in the air.